for my baby and me. Merry Christmas, baby. It's a short of the TV night.
Merry Christmas and welcome to Sports Vision, the magazine. On WTMB, Joe Palo, Mike Cragen, Fajita Palo here getting festive, and Bear Cragen. Fajita didn't have anything to wear, so I'm going to let her wear my hat.
He doesn't want hat.
Hey, look at this. She needs to be, she's Christmased.
Happy New Year, by the way, too, because we're showing this two straight weeks.
Exactly.
We got to roll with this show. This is the great show. We got the best of for the year 2003. Yeah. We're going to show you all the categories, the nominees.
Got a lot of good stuff.
And we're picking them just based on the excitement, and Joe and I are picking them, but you got to like it. You're going to love it. Here we go.
We're picking, and you're grinning.
Starting right now, for the best of 2003, the best game, we're going to start out, Joe, there were three ball games, four basketball games in particular,
also
the Cleveland-Bradley game, the hoopla in that.
Yeah.
And the basketball game, there were four great ones, two of them in particular. We're going to nominate those and show you, but let's start out showing you what happens when Bradley and Cleveland get together. On the football game, you know, the hoopla up front, we're going to show you some of that. There's your nominees.
There they are.
Bradley Cleveland football,
9-7-0-3.
And then, of course, the controversial foul on Kellen Pickle. Let's take a look at the football first. Here we go. Barber, and he's pushing his way. Score! Touchdown for the Blue Raiders.
And Levante fake to him again. They're going deep. It's
got a man
60,
open, wide open. Touchdown.
It's a Blue Raider touchdown. Under center, he's going to roll again, and not much time again. Throws it up, picked off by J.J.
Davis. He's gone.
He will go. Touchdown, Blue Raiders. Here we go. This is Pete Miller.
Pete Miller.
I think they're throwing a pass.
Touchdown.
It's open, and it's picked. And I believe that's Thompson with a pick. He's got some room. He could. He might. It looks like he will. Bradley may get on the board. It's a Bradley Central Bear touchdown. Nobody in sight, picked in the end zone. Touchdown for the Bradley Central Bear. A lot of action in this game, and it looks like we have a
safety.
Sack. It's a safety. Raider defense.
Hey, what a great win there by Leon Brown, the Cleveland
and
Brewers.
And the hoopla around that makes that such a big day, big game. Even though game wasn't that close, it's just great action.
Yeah,
great
of course, as always.
Four basketball games. Let's move on. Between Bradley and Cleveland, let me tell you, they had two of them that were out. All four were outstanding, but two of them that stand out in particular. The next one we're going to go to is the controversy when Trey Mays fouled Kellen Pickle. Cleveland did not think so. Bradley thought so. And we took the side of the foul. We'll show it again.
But
it was
Trey
such
Mays.
A, it was such a Trey Sharp. But it was such a big deal that, you know, it created a lot of controversy.
Oh, was it a big
and
deal?
And set up the
me.
Games to come, and one yeah. would even be better following
yes,
that.
Yes.
But here we go. The foul controversy. He's going to get the board and get undercut there, but still gets it in. And he's going to convert the three-pointer. Look at the Bradley crowd starting to go wild. They were with 4.5 minutes to go, ladies and gentlemen, 14 points down. Cleveland had a huge lead. What happened? Lots of things. Now it's 63-58, 3 minutes to go. But they go cold. Check that out. They can't hit it. They start missing from the free throw line. Bradley comes back. Hammonds would end up making two shots right here to make it 63-60. So Yari's getting them back in. And watch this. It is a jump ball right there. I mean, a block shot right there. So Cleveland just can't score with 4.5 minutes to go. Coming down for 14. Let the Pickle come in. Puts the ball in the hole. And again, futility by Cleveland. Watch this. Not going to happen. Not going to happen. Bradley with the ball, so they just can't hit anything. And here we go, 63-62. This big play, a minute left. Cleveland in the spread. Watch, he's got the ball, and they call that a jump right there. Pickle goes in and gets his hands on it. Was it a jump? That was one of the calls made by Aaron Green's relative right there. Remember that now. Now watch, we're going to show you some other plays of this. Bradley fans going nuts. It was a quick jump ball, but all four hands were on the ball at once. That's... From what I have been reading, the definition of a jump ball, we're going to take a look at it again here in just a minute. But look, see that ball is going to fall down on Pickle here a little bit, too. I'm going to show you. Right now, they call a timeout, 63-62. There's the jump ball from the other angle. Watch. He has both hands on it pretty steady. Watch. And so he had to pull it away. Watch again. Now I'm going to stop it so you can see it in a minute, but not right now. Right there. That is the reach-in foul. Now, anytime you reach across the body, it's almost always a foul. We'll show these things again later. But see the ball will come on the floor right down in front of your screen. Ends up hitting Pickle, so the crowd got rowdy, and people were throwing things. Well, that was the foul with just 6 seconds to go. So they're giving Pickle. They're down one. And cool, as a cucumber, Pickle puts them in, both of them. And the fans are going wild. Cleveland will take it down to half court, call a timeout, 6 seconds to go. So the fans are not believing what they're seeing here as of Bradley Cleveland 2. Charles Little does get a good look at the basket. Last shot, not good, and tries to throw up another one. No way. Now watch Aaron Green coming off the court there, not too happy. Halfway undressing himself as he gets there, and the refs are scooted off the court. Mr. Woodard makes sure that there's security there.
And there's Deputy Moritz right there.
That's right.
He's trying to keep it
off a while. Now, we're going to take a look at these here right along with this package as we go. Package will continue right here. There's a Cleveland assistant coming off the court. Cleveland players obviously distracted. They had it one they thought. And, of course, Bradley fans and Bradley players are chatting. Kent Smith can't believe they came back. This Coach Woodard trying to make sure peace is restored because it got a little hairy. Nothing major going on. A stunned Aaron Green walks through there, 64-63. Keep the tape rolling here. Now, right here. See, both hands are on the ball. We're going to show it to you for a few seconds, then we're going to let it go. You'll see him have to jerk it away. So right there, he does jerk it away. It was called a jump. Quick call. But remember, Aaron Green's cousin. Now watch the foul. Watch the foul. Anytime you reach across in front of somebody, see where he's at? He's reaching across. He's not squared up with him. He's reaching across him, and it is.
Well, I tell you what, that was a ball.
And, you know,
that really wasn't.
The jump ball was iffy, but the foul was definitely a foul.
Yeah.
And we caught some heck for taking that side of it, but I think the tape showed that. And it allowed, the foul allowed Kellen Pickle to make two free throws to allow Bradley two wins. So it was a huge call, but I believe it was the right call. Now, we thought it couldn't get any better.
Yeah.
We thought it couldn't get any better. Cleveland is down 13 points in the next game. And you can imagine the blood feud going on in Raider Stadium. 2,000 people in there in the Raider Dome. My son had to wait outside. He didn't get in until halftime, until people left. The fire code, fire marshal wouldn't let him in. Here it is. It's the better one right here, even four overtimes.
Unbelievable.
Four overtimes. Roll it.
5 minutes to go. Pickle hits a three.
The tap.
There's Pickle. 57-44. Game over.
Shot.
Wrong. Bow water breath. It's not over. 13-point lead. What happens? Sharp hits a layup. Cooper hits two. Davis, two more. And it's 61-53 right there.
Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
Here we go. It's Cooper with the steal. 6 points in a row. Davis, alley-oop. Lay in for four. Two more. 61-57. Coming up 109. Free throw by Sharp. Free throw by Sharp.
He's pretty sharp.
15 seconds left. Down three. The game's not over. Cooper hits the three. 15 to go. Pandemonium. Check out the Cleveland crowd. Are they going wild or what? Here we go. Tied at 62. We're going to go into overtime because neither team can score right there. First points in overtime. Yarish Hammonds will hit one. He's out of your picture, but he is over in the corner. Believe me, he hits a three-pointer. And Bradley now is up four. Cooper hits a three right here in just a minute right here after we get that basket by Suter. Bradley, Cooper hits a three right there to put Cleveland up one.
What count is this?
68. Sharp is going to hit the free throw. Cleveland up two. Over, right? No, whoa, water breath. 5 seconds
you
to go.
You already used that
he
one.
He throws it into Hare. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1.
He splits a hair.
Buzzer goes off. Basket counts. We're into another overtime.
Oh, my goodness.
Somebody needs to get in front of that man right there. Double OT, second OT. Bradley up one. Sharp is going to foul out right here in a minute. Let's get the overtime score for you, though. 72 off, going into it. Watch the foul. A little push right out of your picture. Big play. Sharp went out. Little went out right before him. So some of the Cleveland guns going to the bench. 74-73 Bradley. However, Cleveland's not done. Take the layup right here from Jay Davis, and he's going to get 2 points, 80-79. Bradley Pickle picks Cooper right here. There it is. There's the steal. Goes the distance. Bradley up three. 28 seconds to go. Game over? No. 5 seconds left. Number 31, Levante Barber with the shot. The basket counts. Barber would make it 82 all because he's going to drain the game-tying free throw right there. Bradley with a final shot to win it. As we are tied in triple OT, does it fall?
Double, that was double.
And now we go to triple. At the end of double OT, doesn't fall. Now we go to triple. Pickle.
Will this game end?
It's going to end. Pickle's going to hit the first basket for Bradley. We're tied at 82.
Classic.
Bradley is up two. Bradley's up three. Hare hits a free throw, 90-87. And they hold on to win right here after this free throw. 94-90. Joe, look at the jubilation. We have got the game of the year.
Oh.
And there we go, the best game winner 2003, Bradley at Cleveland, four OTs. Come on, what more could you say? Come on.
Awesome
four
stuff.
OTs.
Our Christmas edition, and I'm telling you, enjoy your Christmas and your New Year's and enjoy these best plays. Now we got the best coach of the year. Of course, there's several in the county. Well, all three schools have some great ones. But I'm telling you, year after year, Coach Leon Brown gets them in there. Let's go ahead and show our nominees.
Great teams.
Coach Leon Brown. Gets there, there they
there
are.
You go.
In Cleveland football year after year, Steve Locks could be coach of the year every year. And if I do that, people are going to think I'm prejudiced. But Bradley Russell is always up there. And Kent Smith, coach of the year for the basketball, finished second in the state.
Yes.
All right.
So good job. Coach Brown, Coach Logston, Coach Smith.
Here we go, and this is Coach Leon Brown. Third straight Sports Vision Trophy in the Bradley-Cleveland game. Six all-region players, all-region coach of the year. Coach Leon Brown has his Raiders in the playoffs the last couple years, celebrating right there the annual Bradley Cleveland game and the Sports Vision Trophy. Coach Leon Brown, first nominee. Second nominee coming up right here. Keep the tape rolling. This is going to be Kent Smith. There's his basketball team. There's a state tournament in Murfreesboro. They're there, and you're going to see Coach getting them ready.
There he is.
For the games. This guy, second trip to the state finals, region champs again, seven straight years, and he had two all-region players. There they are, second in the state, getting the net and the plaque and the basketball. 36-3 last year.
Yeah.
Coach Kent Smith doing an awesome job for the Bradley Bears.
Good guy.
And once again, we say year after year, this guy could get it every year. 11 titles in 12 years, 27 state champions. Steve Logsdon of the Bradley Central Bears, there's your championship trophy from last year. And there's Coach Steve Logsdon at the state tournament being interviewed
by one of the Beatles.
Not enough, John Lennon. So Coach Steve Logsdon, and there's your nominees. Right there, he's coaching his player, and there he is accepting the trophy from a Marine. And there's the team, number one in the state. So Coach Steve Logsdon, Kent Smith.
Hey, Coach of the Year winner, 2000.
Taking in the state, all juniors. Coach Steve Logsdon is expecting to do it year after year, and that probably hurts him. Kent Smith. He is the coach of the year for that second place boys basketball.
Congratulations.
All right, congratulations, Coach Kent Smith. Now, let's move on.
What do we got here?
The next thing we've got is the best team.
Here we go. Team of the Year nominees 2003, the Cleveland football team, the Bradley wrestling team, the Bradley basketball team. Which team would be best?
We're going to take a look here.
Let's check it out.
And this is the Bradley basketball team at Murfreesboro.
Getting pumped up.
One of the state tournament games. And, of course, they have Kellen Pickle, as you'll see right here, Region Player of the Year. Honorable mention All-State.
Yeah.
They had Justin Hare.
Justin Time.
Who was third-team All-State. And, of course, they had Hugh, they had Brown, and they had
Suter.
They had a great team. There's the team accepting the second-place trophy. So they have to be one of our nominees. And there is one of the all-tournament players, Corey Pugh.
Yeah.
He is all-tournament in the state, so that makes him a part of a great team. Justin Hare was third-team All-State and part of that all-tournament team. Of course, Kellen Pickle, part of that all-tournament
36-3, Michael.
36-3. Now we go to the Blue Raider football team. Of course, losing to Knox West in the playoff, but that team, Coach Brown, had them there, region champs again.
One of them right there, big ball players for the Braves.
Jay Davis, who's an all-region player. And there they are getting ready, of course, for the big Bradley-Cleveland game. And they, I believe, we're going to show a little of Levante. There's Davis again.
Davis again.
One of the all-region players. Going for a touchdown against Bradley. And there he is. Levante Barber, of course, going to be a Division I player you might see on TV next year.
Be a fullback somewhere.
So, now, when we get to the Bradley Wrestling, don't forget, shut off the music there, Mr. Director, when we get to him. But when we get to the Bradley Wrestling, right there
we go.
Here, of course, we have got two state champions on this team, the Bradley Wrestling team. Well, Michael Cragen was a state champion. And we have, coming up after Michael, we have Dustin Catlett was a state champion. Now, this is a team. Look at all the placers on this team that they've got coming through. There's Catlett winning his. So we had two state champions on that squad, three finalists. And Dustin Catlett was a second state champion. Then you move along here, you have, I said two state champions. I'm sorry, we have three state champions.
Correct.
Quinn Gibson, of course, three state champions, six finalists. Here's Quinn Gibson.
Quinn the Eskimo. The mighty Quinn.
And Coach Logsdon right there. So this team is a tough, tough team. And here's Quinn Gibson, who, by the way, was the outstanding wrestler in the state of Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
He won the award at the state tournament. So it's hard to get any better than that. Quinn Gibson. So there's three state champions on this team. And as we move along, we've got the music right here showing state champions Michael Cragen, Quinn Gibson, and Dustin Kettler right there. Now your placers after you show a wonderful head coach. As I said, could be coach of the year after year. And some people might give it to him year after year. He does that well. There's Blake Tinsley, second in state.
Blake sporting some nice shorts
at
there.
103 and his 119-pounder, Sean Cordell, second state two-time champion, three-time finalist. That's a great wrestler.
Mark
Fuller, a surprise at fifth in the state at 125 last year.
Mr. Intensity.
130, fourth in the state, Jake West last year.
Jake sporting nice shorts as well.
Michael Cragen at 140, of course. We're showing you all the placers just to show you the strength of this team. There's 14 weight classes, ladies and gentlemen. We got placers in eight of them. Here we go with Dustin Callett, receiving his championship medal. And after Dustin Callett, we have Mr. Quinn Gibson. I mean, this guy can wrestle.
Yeah,
Major
can.
College. He's got two or three big time. Well, he's got several after him, but he's narrowed it down to a couple, two or three big time schools. We'll let you know as soon as we know where Quinn goes.
Good Bryant student Black- as well.
Yes, he is. Bryant Blackman back. Speaking of a good student.
Yeah.
Older brother at Oklahoma State. He got second at 171. 189, Josh Cooper, fifth. What a team that was.
Yeah,
I'm telling you. And there's Coach Logsdon getting his trophy.
How many times are we going to show that?
And there's the team. Best team in the state.
Hey!
Throw up the graphic. There it is. The Bradley Wrestling Team. Team of the year for 2003.
Yes.
Got to keep moving. Congratulations, best team Bradley Wrestling. Play of the year.
I got a bus to move.
Play of the year. We've got the controversial foul we showed you earlier with Kellen Pickle, and we've got Lamar Thompson's run. Let's take a look right here.
110 yards, folks. Not 109 and a half.
So you can see it in a minute, but not right now. Right there. That is the reach-in foul. Now, anytime you reach across the body, it's almost always a foul. We'll show these things again later. But see the ball come on the floor? Right down in front of your screen ends up hitting Pickle, so the crowd got rowdy and people were throwing things. Well, that was the foul with just 6 seconds to go. So they're giving Pickle, they're down one. And Cool, as a cucumber, Pickle puts them in, both of them, and the fans are going wild. Cleveland will take it down to half court, call a timeout, 6 seconds to go. So the fans are not believing what they're seeing here is a Bradley Cleveland team. Charles Little does get a good look at the basket. Last shot, not good, and tries to throw up another one. No way. Now watch the foul. Watch the foul. Anytime you reach across in front of somebody, see where he's at? He's reaching across. He's not squared up with him. He's reaching across him, and it is.
Here we go. This is Pete Miller. I think they're throwing a pass. It's open, and it's picked, and I believe that's Thompson with a pick. He's got some room. He could. He might. It looks like he will. Bradley may get on the board. It's a Bradley Central Bear touchdown. Nobody in sight. Picked in the end zone. Touchdown for the Bradley Central Bears. So a little bit of redemption. Although it's way late, it still is points for the Bears. And they'll take anything they can get right now. As Lamar Thompson picks the football all the way from the end zone. Johnny, what is that, about 108 yards? He was deep in the corner.
He was deep in the end zone.
Kickoff return, here it is. Let's see where he's at on the pick. It looked like it was gonna be a good pass.
Number
but Thompson
five.
Reads it, turns into a receiver himself. I thought it was gonna be a touchdown.
Thompson, number five.
Now watch here as Thompson, great effort. That's just a great effort. Gets back, look where he's got the ball. Now he's turning around right here, oh my goodness.
That's got to be a record. That's 109 and a half yards.
109 and one half yards. So the highlight for Bradley tonight, 109 and a half yard.
That was almost to Eminem Mars.
Return on an interception.
There you go, the play of the year winner 2003, Lamar Thompson's, and I will say, 110-yard interception return. It was a record. They dogged him for a half a yard, and the kid had 110-yard interception.
Unbelievable.
That was unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
What a play.
Well, now we're down to one of the big ones here, players of the year.
Yeah, buddy.
We've got several nominees right here. And we're going to put the nominees up for you. There they are, athlete of the year.
Look at that.
Antonio Westfield, Cleveland baseball, playing for Walter State right now, all region last year. Levante Barber, of course, Cleveland football and baseball, but he was a finalist for Mr. Football.
Yes, he was.
Justin Hare, Bradley basketball. Kellen Pickle, Bradley basketball. Quinn Gibson, Bradley wrestling. Tristan Simpson had a great year in Walker Valley.
Well, give Pickle his just due, basketball, football, and baseball.
All right, let's take a look. There he is, Antonio Westfield, Mr. HR for the Cleveland Raiders the past year in baseball, playing at Walter State now, and looked at to be a possible pro prospect. There's a home run against Bradley right here. Levante Barber, finalist for Mr. Football, doing his thing in the Bradley-Cleveland game, all region for the Raiders. All right, Justin Hare coming up now for Bradley basketball, third team All-State, All-Tournament, and All-Region right there for Bradley. Kellen Pickle.
Who?
Kellen Pickle, Bradley baseball, basketball, and football. All-Region in all three all-around athlete, maybe the best one of the bunch as far as your all-around athlete. Quinn Gibson.
Speaking of an athlete.
Bradley Wrestling, state champion 2 years in a row. And now Tristan Simpson coming at you, carrying that football for Walker Valley. Now, we've got to announce
a drum roll.
We got to announce a winner. All great. And, you know, there's several great ones that could have been left out. So people out there, don't be upset. Tons of great performances. But the bottom line to me is this. Are you the best there is far and above? And
yes, I am.
Two people we can say that about. We can say that about this football player who was finalist for Mr. Football and this wrestler who was voted best wrestler in the entire state of Tennessee. How do you choose who's best? We didn't. We cheat. We didn't cheat. We chickened. Take a look. Here they are.
Drum roll.
Cleveland Football and Baseball was Mr. Finalist. I'm finalist for Mr. Football and all region, of course. Carrying on Brown's team last couple years. And Quinn Gibson, wrestler extraordinaire.
Mighty Quinn,
best wrestler in the state tournament of Tennessee.
All right.
Okay.
On his way to where? Who knows?
I don't know, but we're gonna show you a couple quick commercials. We'll be back to close out this Christmas season and this new year.
So when I heard Hardee's was making their hamburgers out of Angus beef, well, I just flat out didn't believe it. I mean, I've raised Angus beef for 25 years, and I know how expensive it is. Yeah, I just couldn't figure out how they could afford to put Angus beef in their hamburger. So I went into town to try it out. Boy, you could have knocked me over with a feather. They're serving Angus beef hamburgers.
Thick burgers with 100% Angus beef. It's how the last place you'd go for a burger will become the first.
You got a cash emergency, you got a money mayday. We cash your personal check and then we hold it till you're paid. You wanna get your money in a hurry, in a flash. You want it from a friendly place that's got a lot of class.
Check in the cash, check in the cash.
Hey, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from our Sports Vision family to yours. Look, here comes Fajita out of the hat
again. Best of 2003. We're looking for a great 2004. Everybody enjoy the holidays.
We'll see you.